What's up, guys? Anklespankin here, and today we are playing as Olaf in the top lane. And we are going to be, well, I guess pretty much just trying this out. Because I haven't played Olaf in many a month, especially not in top lane. And we are going to be going against the new Fiora. Well, not really new anymore, but the reworked Fiora, as in whatever recently. Super broken Fiora is basically what I'm saying. So we'll see how much fun we'll be able to have this game. But, gonna just start with cloth armor here, because it is an AD lane, so that should help us stay in it a little longer. Anyways, before we get too into this game, I want to let you guys know that I do deeply apologize. I am very, very, very sorry. For the next 4 or 5 days or so, I will not be able to put out more League videos. Because I will not be home. I will be in TwitchCon, or at TwitchCon in San Francisco. If you guys are going to be there, make sure you do look for me and say, hey. If you're not, well, I'm sorry. but I simply did not plan ahead well enough. I really do apologize. I feel horrible about it, in all honesty, that I won't have League videos out for you guys. But I will at least have Soma videos out every day that I'm gone. So at least there's something you can still watch. Like I said, I am sorry, though. I hope you guys still find some enjoyment out of that. So, with all that said, I will be back on, Tuesday? Yeah, I should be back on Tuesday, and we'll be right back into League of Legends there. So, once again, for the last time, I'm very sorry. But let's get this show on the road. We are playing with some of our friends. We got Nexivus on that jungle Echo, Tish on the AD carry Jinx, Simus on the mid lane Katarina, and Diabetic Cactus on that support Thresh. We are going against a huge grizzly bear on that Nidalee jungle, a Blitzcrank Ashe bot lane, Fiora top, like I said, and Zed in the mid lane. So, going against this Fiora, I have no idea exactly what to expect, especially in this matchup. I don't know what to max on Olaf. I don't know what to build. I don't know what I'm doing. So basically, we're gonna wing it, and we'll hope for, well, for the best. So let's go ahead and see. She did start off with her lunge. Let's go ahead and get an auto attack off there. Go ahead and chuck my axe in her face, and let's see. She started with a longsword and 3 health potions. It looks like she is going for a lot of damage on me, and it is working out for her. So let's go ahead and just get some more pain right there, and try and let these potions tick us up a little bit, because she has brought us dangerously low already, and that's not very good for us. But first blood gonna be going down for the Nidalee onto our Echo. So Nexivus, dirty feeder dog, will be bringing himself down. And let's see here. I don't know again what ability she got at level 2. I decided to get my Reckless Swing because that does not even cost me any mana. Where with my Undertow, I've been kind of, you know, bringing it in. And let's go ahead and beat her up a little bit there. That'll show her a thing or two. Go ahead and give her an auto attack here. Give her another Q right there. Go ahead and this will be a boom. Wait, no. Hail no. Oh, don't lunge, don't lunge, don't lunge! Boom! That's gonna be the kill, brother! Picking it up, Reckless swinging right in her face, going to be picking up that kill, ghosting after her. I bet she was freaking the fuck out, but it looks like the rest of my lanes are a bunch of dirty feeders so far, and that is okay, because Olaf will bring in the carry, and let's see. So I know that what's-her-face, Fiora, doesn't have her flash, so she's gonna teleport, and she's not going to be able to kill us, because she's not going to be able to catch us. So let's see, do I want to level up my Q, or do I want to level up my E? I think I'm going to want to level up my E in this lane. So I'm actually going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to go back here, and she did just get boots on that back. So let's see, I'm going to go for, let's see, I might just grab the Ninja Tab right off the bat here. Now, this seems like kind of a weird build, and that's because, honestly, it is. I usually wouldn't go straight for Ninja Tabi in most lanes, but considering how just how much damage a Fiora's is done through her auto-attacking, I feel like it'll be worth it. So, I don't know why I didn't just teleport back here, but I'm not going to bother now at this point, because she's not even pushing under my tower for one thing, and another thing, like, I'm already, like, 3/4 of the way there, so whatever. But getting the Ninja Tabi this early will, of course, give us a little more armor. But on top of that, it will also reduce the amount of damage her auto attacks do, and that's pretty important. So let's go ahead and just run over here and see if I can smack her on the ass, and come on, come on. So I think I'm actually going to go for a time map in this lane, because that will build right into our Titanic Hydra, because that sounds like fun. That sounds like a lot of fun, honestly. So let's go ahead and just slow her down there a little bit. Will not work, because I'm the worst, And let's see. So I'm thinking that I'm just going to count on Reckless swinging her face every time she goes for a lunge on me. Because I think that's how I'm going to just have to trade with her in general. So I think that's going to work out for the best, for in our benefit even. So if I level this up constantly, keep reducing that cooldown with the auto attacks, and just keep bringing it in, that should be good. Because the more she lunges in on us, the better, like, the lower she'll get, because she can't heal through all of my reckless swings. So let's go ahead and just get another one on her right there. Slow her down a little bit. This gonna be another kill for me if she ain't careful. So let's see here. And got the slow. Come here, baby. Boom! That's gonna be another reckless swing right down her spine. Killing her ass just like that. 2-0 up here on this Olaf. Fiora is not having a good time. So let's go ahead and just level up the Ragnarok now. And see if we can push this wave out. So let's go ahead and just run back here, run past the wave, grab our axe again, throw it straight over there, get that minion, and kill this guy right here. Whoop, get that siege, and shabam. Wait, I fucking missed it. Rip. All right, well, we can go back again with our 2-0 lead now and a 16 CS lead on this Fiora, and we can grab some components of the Tiamat. Or we can go for a Sterax gauge. I know I'm going to go for a Dead Man's Plate. That item will be so good in this game, especially on the Olaf. Basically, I'm going to be going for a bunch of new items right now. And once again, I'm not sure if I should even bother teleporting at this point. Because by the time I get there, it's just going to be back at my tower. I'm not really missing anything by not teleporting, so I don't think it'll be worth it for me. I could try and teleport bottom, so maybe if they go for the dive... It looks like they're not going for it. So I'm not going to teleport in there. And let's see. Shaboink. See if I can get that. It looks like we do have Nex coming in to try and do something here. He is going to drop the... He's not going to do anything yet. He's actually just standing there. So it looks like our mid laner having a hard time against the Zed. 1-3 so far. Building an Aether Wisp even. First, which is not the good idea to go against the Zed. Let's see. I don't know. Go ahead and throw a Q right there and just drop it. And we'll just walk up here and walk away. Because obviously she's terrified of us right now. Level 7 to a level 5. What's she gonna do? She gonna poke me with that little toothpick of hers? Just like that? And then she's gonna get dicked. So come here, bitch. Ooh, yeah, brother. Alright, I'm gonna miss that one. But, you know, whatever. Whatever. So let's go ahead and see if she wants to do it again. You wanna do it at again, huh? You wanna do it at again, little girl? Come here. And let's see if I can just... Oh, what are you doing? Get another bop on the noggin right there just for a little one of those. And there's her level 6. The grand challenge has been issued, but she's not dropping it on us for obvious reasons. Come here. Yeah. Bringing her down quite low already. It looks like Katarina wants to come up and try and get a dive off up here. Now, ideally, if we do get this dive off, I am going to let her get the kill. So let's go ahead and see. This is the challenge. This should be... Maybe the kill? Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and pop Ragnarok. Run flying after her, come here! That's gonna be slowing her down, and bam! Smack! Boop! Go ahead and give her a little kiss right there, and smack her right there, and walk away. Because I don't really have anything better to do here. It looks like Zed is gonna come over this wall, and I might be going down here, and by might being, I will for sure. So definitely gonna die right there. It is okay. It happens. Let's go ahead and grab some more HP potions. Let's go ahead and grab a little bit of that. And let's see. This could be good down bottom. The teleport coming in. It looks like that will be... Whose teleport is that? Fiora's teleport. Oh, no. Fiora is back in this game. Oh, no. The hook landed. And Tish is going for a little bit of something, but she's dead. So that's not good. That is not good for us. So maybe I could have teleported on that, but I don't have my ghost or my ultimate, so I don't know if that would have been good. So let's see if Nex can do this. He is going to be doing some damage right there. Chrono Break, maybe? No, he's not going to do it. So there's the Ignite. He is going to have to Chrono Break if he wants to have any chance of living. Flashing out of that, and let's see if... Is he going to get out of this? Maybe. Uh-oh, it looks like Zed will stop him from getting out of it. Good night, Nex. So 3-1 here on this Olaf. Everyone else 1-4-1, 0-1, 0-2, 0-1. Oh well. All right. So, I mean, that's okay. We'll just have to do some hardcore Olaf carrying. So, maybe we can bust in the carry pants. Maybe, you know, throw up a little gang signs or something as we chuck axes down their throats. For now, though, let's not focus on such brutal things as murder, and focus on such little petty things as, well, murdering little helpless innocent minions that are destined to die and be gold in my pocket. That's horrible. So let's go ahead and go right back to the... Actually, you know what? No, I like where we are. So we're gonna get this, and let's see here. So far, so good on these minions. And huge grizzly bears on a killing spree. That's not very good. And I still don't see a good opportunity for me to teleport anywhere, so I'm avoiding doing it. But I'm gonna use this mana potion. I need to probably be very careful due to the fact that I think Nidalee might be coming up here. And with the Runeglaive, she might be able to kill me with the help of whatever his face is. So let's go ahead and slow him down. Nope. JK. Well, I'm definitely not going to catch him. So let's see Zed coming in too. This could be good. So let's go ahead and drop that on him. That will slow him down. And let's see, maybe, bam, going to do a bunch of damage right here. And pop the Ragnarok and floop. And boom, that's going to be one kill. Come here. I'm not going to really do anything else. But, you know, we can still make it look cool. 420 blade. Sorry, I was just looking at my score a little bit. 420, and let's see what we can do. So who killed me? It should have been the Zed, I think. And I'm definitely going to need to get, I'm going to need that dead man's plate a lot sooner than I may have thought I would have. But that is A-okay. We're definitely going to need that pronto. And let's go ahead and teleport up on here, because there is a rather large minion wave scaling on up there. And by rather large, I mean it's going to be this wave, and then the next wave crashing into it. So we'll just bust that out. Using our Tiamat, we will be able to get most of it much easier. And actually, the Tiamat makes our true damage thing do a lot more damage as well. So our Reckless Swing will be hurting more. So let's see. Ghost is back up. My Ragnarok is something that we should definitely keep in mind the power of as well. Because that's something that, even though it sacrifices some of our resistances. Uh-oh. Alright, so let's see. What? That hit me? Alright, you know what? That's fine. That's fine. I'm ready to scrap. I'm ready. Alright, let's see it. And boink. Pick up one kill just like that. Walk out and slow her down a little bit. And I'm out of here. So see you later. Get me out of here. And that will be me living through this one. We'll pick up the kill on the Nidalee, reducing that effectiveness of her Medgeyes. What a terrible purchase. And we'll be getting out of there, no problem. So gonna pick up another Ruby Crystal for my dead man's plate. And we'll see what's going down. So Sivir, or not Sivir, but Katarina is 171 so far. Not so hot yet. Well, let's see. We do have our Titanic Hydra at least now. So that should help a decent amount. And we will be able to just... I need to be tanky enough this game to just live. Because Olaf does a lot of damage anyways. But I really need to just be tanky enough to do nothing but live. So let's go ahead and just slow him down here. I'm going to pop the ultimate just for that increased movement speed. Let's go ahead and just bop her on the ass with that one. And she will try and jump over the wall there. My Q has landed. And let's see, maybe, damn it, not gonna nail her in the ass there. So Nex is going for this. Will he find it though? I'm not sure. That was a really long flash on her part, by the way. I don't know if you guys saw that, but that was a very long flash. He will still get the kill though. So even though that was a great, really, really long range flash, she flashed from here to there. She will not be escaping that with her life. But let's see, can I get this tower? I think I might be able to. Never mind, my attack speed is very low right now. And I don't have my Vicious Strikes up. So I'm going to just walk away and push off of the next wave. So let's go ahead and just do that. Clear this whole wave with an Undertow straight through the middle of it. And now we'll get this tower. So pop the Vicious Strikes, bring this tower down. I should be able to actually just split push for quite a while this game. Because if they try and handle me, it's going to take their very fed people to handle me. They can't just send anybody to kill me. It's gonna have to be Zed. And if they actually team fight without Zed right now, that should go in our favor. Because Zed is such a massive factor for their whole team. So, looking at it that way, we should be good. But it looks like Thresh will get hooked. I need to back off because I know Zed was mid and now I don't know where he is. And without armor right now, I'm probably going to die. So let's see, is Zed going to go for it? He will ult. So without Zed's ultimate, this could be a good opportunity. Oh, he will get the return kill because Zed is getting cocky. And that will definitely be some good money going into our Katarina's pocket. Some very desperately needed money as well at that. So let's see what we can do here. So I do have enough money to get a giant's belt or my, whatever it's called. What's that other item called? The chain vest, the armor item. So we'll see where we can go from there. First of all, though, let's go ahead and just, well, let's chuck an axe straight through these guys. And whoop, kill this. Whoop. Well, I'm not going to kill that one, but, you know, whatever. We'll try. So anyways, we'll just go ahead and work on this tower some. I do have my teleport up in case Fiora decides to get too aggressive on that top lane turret. So let's see. I do have them coming in. Let's go ahead and just jump on her. Shaboom! That should be a lot of damage going off here. I'm going to go ahead and pop the ghost, and I'm out of there. So whatever. I'm out of there. Peace! Looks like the hook will come out, and I'm just going to fly back in there, throw an axe. And he doesn't have any mana, so not going to do much there. And with Zed coming in, shouldn't be much of an issue. So, just walking away from that Fiora, she's not going to be able to kill us. And we will be able to get our giant spell and our chain vest on this back. So very, very soon we'll actually have the dead man's plate. And that'll be a very good, good breakpoint for us. After that, we will need to probably get a Randuin's, I'm thinking, will be pretty good. Frozen Heart is actually still a good option. But I kind of want to get more HP as well, so I'm not sure if that's going to be the first thing I go for, but let's go ahead and just do this. I think she's in there. Hey, I found her! So, not going to let her back in case that's what she was trying to do. So, not today, says Olaf. Go ahead and chuck an axe right there. And let's see if I can find her again. Is she trying to back? Is she trying to back? No, she ain't. So let's go ahead and just... Oh, barely missed that one, sadly. And let's see. Boop! See if we can slow her down some. That will be enough of a slowdown right there to slow her down a lot. And let's see. Maybe. Come on. I don't have enough abilities, but we can still win a fight. It seems so. Whoa, that's not good. Maybe. Ramp. Oh, I had a really huge feeling that she would go for that and try and kill me, but it's not going to work out in her favor. So let's see here. Is she going to go for this too? Whatever. So let's... No! God damn it! Zed was up here! All right. Not going to be able to pick up that kill, but we will get a little landmark. So let's see. This could be good mid. Looks like Katarina going to get hooked out of her ultimate. Echo will pick up one kill. Super Mega Death Rocket picking up the other one. That's good. Uh-oh, that's not good, though. Zed coming in. The Death Mark coming out. Chrono Shift or Chrono Break will save his life. Holy outplays by Nex. Will be keeping him alive. Holy guacamole. And Katarina's dead. But the hook will land. That will be... Oh, okay. A very, 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 very unnecessary flay for the KS. But... Still, killing Zed is good. We will get that mid tower off of it, and that is also very good. Now, I'm thinking now we have Dead Man's Plate, 175 armor, I might go for a Spirit Visage and a Frozen Heart, because Spirit Visage will give me some MR for the Nidalee, which I don't know if I really need, per se, but it'll also increase my healing, it'll also give me some CDR, it'll also give me a bunch of health, so overall, a very good item. So let's go ahead and just see if I can... Let's keep her slowed and whomp. Hey, come on, we can talk. So I'm just gonna back off and whomp, just chuck that through that whole wave. I was gonna use that momentum auto attack right there to try and slow her ass down, but you know, whatever. So I need to be careful, don't know where they are. Looks like Nidalee's right there. Hello, Nidalee. So I'm not gonna, oh, I totally could have stolen that, whatever. So let's see, I'm just gonna walk away here. Still don't know where Zed is, and even though I do have Dead Man's Plate, he does have a Last Whisper already, so he's pretty scary. Not gonna hit me with that, not gonna hit me with that. So I know he doesn't have a shadow, but he is still Zed. So, I don't know if I really wanna... I don't know if I wanna try much, you know what I'm saying? But there is an Ash over here who's looking... Oh. Hey, Ash. Hey! Oh my goodness, that was a long-range attack, and the Q will land! That's gonna nail her! Come here, bitch! Ba-boom! Picking up a kill right there on the Ash, and let's see what we can do. It looks like she has been stopped. The hook will land! Deathmark coming out, and I'm just gonna chill in the back here. Slow down this Blazkronk, and let's see Zed going to jump back over here, and floop! Oh, that Zonya's beautifully timed will pick up the... kill for myself, and let's see, can we do this? Will he be slow enough? And the Q coming in, not wait, did that land? I don't know, but oh, it totally did land, and we will get another kill. This game is turning around 19 to 25 so far, and that is so much better because as soon as we can kill this Zed, this is good. This is looking good. I am a big boy right now as well, so if I can keep getting bigger and bigger, it ain't gonna matter. So let's see, what's this Fiora gonna do? What she thinks she's gonna do? She's gonna get smacked in the head, that's what she's gonna do. But Ash is, well, another story. I didn't even use my ultimate that time either, and I think we probably should have gotten the dragon off of that. But it's okay, it's okay. Wait, this could be good, this could be good, this could be good. So let's see, this is something we can totally fight, 100% fight. So let's, oh, don't back off. Hey-yas! Yeet the axe to my face! Wait. Okay, you know what? Fuck you! Fuck you! I was in a little too deep to get out of there. So, I got hooked. I tried to actually pop the Ragnarok before I got hooked, so I wouldn't get pulled into them. So, my mistake on being very late on that reaction. It happens. What you gonna do? Like I said, I'm not tanky enough yet. But let's see. How much of that was... physical damage, magic. Oh gosh. So it was a bunch of magic and true damage. You can't really build resistances against true damage, but you can build a spirit visage, which will help in general quite a lot. So I think I'll actually go for that. Even though a lot of damage I'll be taking this game is physical, I still thoroughly believe that getting the spirit visage will be very worth it for me. So I will get that, and we'll see how it goes. I don't think I can duel this guy, if we're going to be honest, so I'm probably going to try to avoid that situation, but we'll see, we'll see. So he could be doing that blue, it wouldn't surprise me one bit, he totally is, and let's see him, ah, damn it, alright, wait, gonna go ahead and hit him with another axe, that will be the death mark coming out, he's probably going to jump back to the other one, but it ain't going to matter, so Zed down, and come here. Olaf wants to play. Olaf wants to play! Come here. Come on. Olaf. Damn it. Olaf won. Oh, shit. Olaf won. Alright, I'm gonna pop the Ragnarok so we can just get out of this one. So, I'm out of there. Peace. Whoop. So there were four of them. Olaf doesn't want any more. And that will be getting me out of there. So Blazkronk is gonna be working on it. Getting axe to the face, nerd. We'll be getting axe in the face. So my ultimate will be back up in a minute. That is something I should definitely try and possibly wait for if I can, because Olaf is a very linear champion, if you guys haven't picked up on that yet. Basically, I run at people, and if I don't kill them, then that's not good. And if I get kited, then that's not good. So, you know, long story short, I need to make sure that I have all of my speedy stuffs ready to go if I'm going to do anything here. So let's see, will he be getting the stun? He will not get it, sadly, but let's see here. Nailing the axe to the face. Zed is bottom right now, so if we actually tried to fight, this would be a good time for us. Wait, is Fiora going like tank Fiora? What? What? Alright, you know what? Come here. Come here. Whamp. Bop. Bop, 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 and bop, bop. Actually, this isn't working. I'm going to go ahead and pop the Ragnarok, pop the Ghost, and... Oh. Alright, well, they used a lot of flashes there. I will be going down. This is not good. I need to get some more items. I really badly need to get more items. So Fiora with all of her true damage is really wrecking me now, and that's not good. But it looks like Fiora will go down. Nex is going to get a kill. He is going to chrono break out of there using that Q. He is going to find himself getting out of the whole situation. But actually, you know what? That was about as good as it could have gone for him. We still need more items. I need to be farming. I need to be split pushing. I need to stop trying to fight because I apparently don't do near as much damage as I believe in myself for doing. I need to either just go for carries or try and team fight. I can't really have this middle ground where I kind of try and skirmish because I'm not strong enough to do that. Not one bit am I strong enough to do that. So I'm actually going to teleport to this and see if I can get her. So whoop, there we go. Got the slow. If she ults me, I'm going to go ahead and just pop the ult and kill her ass. So even though I did lose this tower, still will be getting the kill off on Ash. That will be good. And let's see, can I do anything down here? It looks like the teleport's coming in. Zed is trying to go rampaging down here. But he will find himself in the middle of a bad situation. And boom, found an Olaf. But looks like, let's see, you want some too? That's going to be slowing her down again with that axe. And let's just see here, slow her again, going to miss, but she's going to walk out of this range. And pretty soon here, she ain't going to get out of it. So come here, you can run, but you can't hide. Go ahead and miss another axe, but that's okay. Throw another axe, and that's okay. Keep throwing axes because eventually one's going to hit. And that will finally be the one that matters. And actually, I'm not doing enough damage anyways because I forgot she's a tank. So let's see, we do have what's-his-face in here though, so I am tanking this tower, and that will be totally fine for us, so let's go ahead and see, maybe here, maybe, boom, not gonna land it, but that's okay, so wait, boop, let's go ahead and just do as much damage here as we can, drop this true damage, drop the bop, and I am taking a lot, I am gonna go down, but let's see, we'll get that, flashing over, Gromp will not be picking up that kill right there. Hawkshot coming out, not going to do much at all other than, you know, spookify him a little bit. And let's see. So, getting the Spear Visage now will help us out. Finally, we got that. So, do I want to get the Frozen Heart, though? Because now that I'm thinking about it more, I'm kind of feeling more and more like the CDR probably won't be really worth it as much as me just wanting to be able to be faster or trying to basically just not die. I think Randuin's will actually be a better choice here because of all the crit damage they're doing to me. Plus, it'll give me a chance to slow them. And also, in general, be tankier. I think it will be better for me to get a Randuin's here. Because after Randuin's, I think I'm going to get a Thornmail. And Thornmail scales better as well the more life you have. And Frozen Heart doesn't give any HP. So definitely a better choice if you just look at it that way. So this game is definitely going ways. It's going ways. I don't know what way, but it's going ways. So let's see here. Dragon's up. My teleport is not up. So if they go for this, I need to get something up top. Because if I don't get anything up top and we lose another dragon, that'll be their third dragon. Granted, it's not the most important dragon in the game, but third is still pretty impactful. So I don't know where any of them are. Zed I see on the map. Nidalee I see on the map. Blitzcrank I see on the map. I can get this. As long as I do it quickly, I should be able to get this pretty safely. So let's go ahead and just walk away here. Looks like she is going for me. I'm going to go ahead and pop the ghost and the ultimate. Get myself out of here. Because after she pokes me for the third time, or the fourth time here, whatever. And I'm out. So, she's definitely not going to catch me. Going to slow her down right there with the ghost. And I do have my momentum still up. We'll be getting out of there. And it looks like, even without Fiora, my team couldn't handle them at all. Not even in the slightest. So that's not very good. But that's okay. It's okay. It's not good, but it's okay. So they could be going for Baron. I might try and get something here. So let's see. Bam, 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 bam. Uh-uh. Oh, come on. Whoop. No. Come back. Come back. Eh. Damn it. Eh. Come on. Yes. Come on. God damn it. I hate this game. I hate it. I hate everything. I hate everything. Fuck. I hate everything. I'm the worst, and they still got the Baron, dude. Man, this game is tough. All right. So I still actually don't know what Olaf can really do. Looks like next we'll be picking up one kill, though. Maybe gonna get multiple. The flash coming out. They are going to get. Oh, that is Ash gonna go down as well. And I don't think they're gonna get Nidalee. Simmet. Ooh, gonna flash over that wall. But it's not looking like he's gonna get it. So the spear will land, and he's gonna go down for sure. So the greed coming out will not pay off, though. So let's grab a ruby crystal here to build even further into our Randuin's. The flay will knock him away. So let's see. That is a Fiora ultimate coming out on him there. And that'll be the flash over the wall. The flash over the wall. It looks like the hook will take him into an echo. So let's see. Can I get there in time to help? Maybe. I don't know. All right, I'm coming. Gonna chuck this spear in her face. Drop the damage. Look at that. Look at that. Bringing it in. And, well, you know what? She's gonna get out of there. So, well, at least no one died on our team. That is the good news. So, look at the bright side. Look at the bright side. Always look at the bright side of things. So, 235 armor. We definitely need to level up. We definitely need to get that Randuin's completed, and we really need that thorn mail. Because I think after I get those items, I'll be much better off right now than I am currently. Not just because, obviously, you know, I'll be a six-item Olaf, but because it'll actually help a shit ton to have those. So let's throw this right there. Barely, barely miss her gooch. But, you know, that's okay. Maybe I didn't want to touch the gooch right now. So the spear will land, whatever. Oh, the hook will land. That's not whatever. I'm just gonna walk this way. Meow, meow, meow. Slow him down a little bit. Meow, and walk out. So next could be in a bad situation here. And the, yep, next is dead. Okay. Well, I am Olaf, so I'm not gonna die, obviously. Of course not. I would never die. I am Olaf. I am Olaf, King of Champions. The hook will land. What is he doing? He's lost his goddamn marbles! What? What? Oh no. Oh boy. Alright, well, let's go ahead and see what we can do here. Drop some true damage. Show him that I mean the business. And let's, you know what, fuck this, fuck you! There we go. Fuck that super minion right there. And let's go ahead and chuck an axe right there. And maybe I can get another one. Okay. He's not falling for it. What, that didn't land? Wait, is he actually doing this? Oh, he is doing this. Because all he had to do was just, like, auto-attack the Jinx. So I thought he'd lost his mind because he was jumping on me instead of Jinx, but no, he had it all planned out. So we will get one kill, the teleport coming in, and that's not going to be enough. Ash going to go down as well. Will he be able to get this one? Next, just auto-attacking. He's right-clicking as hard as he can. Thresh going to come in here, kind of walk around everywhere. There's the hook. Will it be enough? The flay coming out, using that smite on the minions to heal up a little bit. There's the parry. Will block the damage? I don't know. Oh, God, there's the shield. There's the hook. Moving him out. There's the chrono shift back into the lantern. And he's going to make the great escape. Damn. And let's see what your boy can do. So coming in, faster than a flaming spider monkey. Gonna fly in there. Shaboom! There's gonna be one kill. And let's see, popping the ghost right here. I'm gonna go ahead and... You can't get away from me. You're not gonna get away. You're not gonna get away, brother. You're not gonna get away from me, brother. Oh, fuck, I missed. All right. You know what? He's still not gonna get away. Wait, how is he so fast? Stop being so fast! Yaha! I hit him in the gooch! And he is definitely going down. Boop! That's gonna be the kill right there. So, wait, this is still up? Can I just kill this? Fuck yeah, fuck yeah, fuck yeah. Why is this tower still here? I don't want this here. Tower gonna go down, though. Let's see, Nex is trying to duke it out with the Zed. Can he do it? Can he do this? No. No, not even remotely close to being able to do that. So, next going to get murderized right there by the Zed. So let's see. Come here. I'm not going to do that. I changed my mind. It's a prank, bro. It's a prank. It was all just a great prank, man. All right. Boop. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Tish is probably going to go down. Yep. And I mean, I can't really do anything to this guy. Yeah, wait, this could be good? No, it's not going to be good. So Zed's a little fed. Zed's a little fed. And I am not, like, I don't know if I can even get tanky enough to be able to, like, fight him. I truthfully don't think I can. Not with how Zed works. So, this is going to be a tough one. It's looking like a long shot, but it's definitely not still impossible yet. Still not impossible. He can still die. Gods can bleed. The Chrono Break will be picking up the kill on Ash. So that's pretty good. That's pretty cool. Go ahead and bop a little further. He's definitely not going to get that. So there's the smite on the Gromp. Let's see. Jinx could try and do stuff, but she... Oh my goodness, she is very far behind right now. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. So let's see, maybe I can do something. No, I doubt it. I really doubt it. So they're probably going to go get that dragon. So that'll be their fourth dragon. Let's see. Ooh, come here. Fuck yeah. Ooh, fuck yeah. Come on. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, yeah. Picking up that kill right there on the Nidalee, brother. We'll be picking up that. But that will be their fourth dragon. We should... I feel like we need to get the Baron. I really feel like we should try and get the Baron. Baron in 30. We should probably try to rush that, maybe? I think that could be, like, our only option at this point. So the hook will not land, but here I come on that lantern. So let's see. All right. Come on. Come on. Come on. Wait. Got the... Yes. No. No. Yes. All right. Zed's coming in the back. We need to do something about this guy. We need to do something about this guy. Everybody, dogpile! Get him! Just fucking dogpile him! Wait. This is our chance. This is our chance. Baron? Maybe? Maybe? I feel like we should just go for the Baron. I feel like we're just on a wild goose chase at this point, and we're losing our base. Oh, never mind. Nex has got it. So without Nex, I don't think we should try and do that, but I want to go get my Randuins. So, no, let's all back off. Zed's too fast, he's too powerful, he's too brawny to do anything. So let's go ahead and throw this on 3-key. Try and make it so it's an accessible button for us to push. And maybe with my ghost, I can possibly get that Ash. Dead Ash. But I'm not sure. So Zed... Ah, Zed, stop! Oh, wait! Yes, I'm fine. But they got Baron. They just got Baron. That's not good. But we got the Zed. That is good. So maybe this could be good. The flash hook onto Ash. That is huge. All right, Thornmail, where are you? Where are you? Get the cloth. Get the cloth armor. So let's go ahead and teleport right here. Hello. Hello. Go ahead and just slow him down a little bit by taking his life. And maybe we can also get this Fiora. Maybe Nex will live. And let's get this tower as well. Because I can... Oh, hello. Hello. Womp, 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 womp. You think I'd give a hoot, son? Think I'd give a hoot? So let's see here. Maybe we can... Okay, I'll tank this. I'll tank it. I'm running forward to tank it. Let's do it. Let's do it. All right. Tanking it. Tank strategy, go. Oh, that hook! That's gonna be... Oh. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and walk out of here and bloop, pop that Randuin's and, well, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and walk over here. Zed is up, though, so we need to get the fuck out of here. Does he have home guards? Oh, he does. Uh-oh. Whatever. We got two towers. That's gonna be good. So, maybe... Oh, the hook will land, and Tish could definitely kill this as long as she doesn't do that. Okay. Maybe. All right. God damn it! God. Oh, this is bad. This is really bad. This is not good. This is the opposite of good. All right. So let's see here. Whoop! Not gonna get hit by that one. Let's go ahead and dead man's plate. Super speedy mode. I'm gonna get myself out of here. The hawk shot coming in. Not gonna matter. So let's see. Looks like he will get that inhibitor. Throw the axe in her face. But I'm not sure I want to try and do anything with that. So, at least we got the Baron off of a lot of them. That will be good. We got an open inhibitor up top. I still haven't upgraded my trinket, but fuck that. So, I really want to save the money for getting my, what's it called? My thorn mail, because I really, really would like to have that. That would be terrific. That would just be grand. So let's see. We do have the bottom inhibitor. Since it's gone, there's not a lot we can really do or say about this one right here. But that's okay. That is A-okay. Let's see it. Let's see it so that won't land. But this will. Come here. Ooh, yeah. Gonna go ahead and slow him down. Slow all three of them down. Let's go ahead and pop this Randuin's right here. Doing a bunch of damage. All right, I'm gonna pop the Ragnarok right here. See if I can kill this guy. That's gonna be one kill going down. And let's see it. Tish could be doing so much damage right now. And let's see. This is the fight we needed. And I'm gonna go down. But Nex is still up right there killing everything. And Tish is in the base. Okay. Tish, run in. Auto attack. Tish, do the thing. Tish, do the thing. Do the thing. There's one thing. Next gonna come in. They're doing the things. Just shoot them. Just shoot them, goddammit. Just shoot them. Just shoot them all. Come on. Yeah, brother. And that will be... Oh, look at this. Look at... Yay. We came out on top of that. And they should maybe... I don't know if they'll be able to win. But that will be the inhibitor going down. I don't know if they'll be able to get this turret either. Shit, I don't think so. They don't have the minions for it. Yeah, I don't think this is a good idea. I think this is actually quite the bad idea. So I'm gonna go ahead and ping them back, even though they probably, like, 100% know. But still, we got an inhibitor down. That's good. This... Oh my god, this game is playing with my heartstrings, man. This game is definitely playing with my heartstrings. So 318 armor. Zed with double Infinity Edge build. Not given a hoot. So, Zed double IE. That's probably the worst thing you can do right now. That's just not a good idea at all. He should probably get something more useful than a second Infinity Edge. Like, a Bloodthirster to live? Or literally any damage item? Oh, that's not good. That was their fifth dragon. So they really badly need to not die here. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. I was not paying attention. And I feel really stupid now because we could have probably prevented that, but we didn't. Shit. Shit, shit, shit. I feel really stupid, honestly. So that's really bad. What the fifth dragon does is it makes it so every one of their attacks does 150 true damage over 3 seconds. It doubles the impact of every other bonus. Wait, this could be good. So let's pop the Ragnarok right here. This is a lot of damage going off. Hell yeah, run after him. Right now, this is exactly what we need. And pop the Randu and slow him down. That's going to be a dead Zed. Did we just win? No way, no way, no way. Alright, I'm going to push this wave down, because if I can get through to mid, this could be good. This could be good. So only Jinx is down. Nex is playing with Nidalee. Will die, actually, because he got sniped by the spear. Nex, Noob Lord, going to be losing his own life to that. But who is up? Ashe is up, Nidalee is up. So I'm going to go back right here. I ain't know that I'm gonna do, so I'm just gonna, let's see. I don't know if I can kill her. I mean, I could if I have my ultimate, but I don't have my ultimate, so definitely not gonna get that. That is a dead Nidalee. Good. Good. Another little window of opportunity of safety. If we rush Baron while Nid down, could be good. Because Nidalee will be down when Baron spawns, still for another 15 seconds. Next, we'll have to get there really fucking fast, though. So let's see. I'm actually going to get this trinket. And then I think I'm going to get a different elixir, actually. Because getting the tenacity elixir doesn't make a lot of sense on Olaf. So let's see. I'm going to get the elixir of ruin. Because that'll give me more HP to synergize with my thorn mail. So this is the part of the game that's kind of making or breaking it. And we really... We have to do this. We absolutely have to do this right now. We might lose our bottom inhibitor for it, but we can't afford to not do this right now. So I'm going to drop the pink and get this rolling. They do not have immediate vision of it, so this could be really good. So maybe, all right, here it comes. Yeah, We got this. We got this Baron. That's the Ash Arrow down. And Echo has slain the Baron. Fiora going for that back door. And it looks like Thresh will go down, but we will be able to lose one inhibitor in exchange for Baron. I think that's worth it, in my opinion. In my honest opinion, that's very worth it. So, we got the Baron. As long as we get the next dragon as well, that will be very good. But we did lose Thresh. That is not good. Shit. God damn. So let's see. Fiora's backing. I don't know. I don't know what our windows of opportunity are looking like right now. So Zed chilling off in the wings. He has. Why does he have three Infinity Edges? He actually sold his Blade of the Ruined King for a third Infinity Edge. What? What? He's selling his survivability and chase potential to try and just pop someone. That's not good for him. But this could be good for us. The flash out. Nex is just going ham. Going to be doing so much. And there's the Chrono Break getting him out of there. So, definitely being a bit of a monster, if you will. And it looks like that will be the Enchanted Crystal Arrow. I'm going to go ahead and just pop out of that and pop back in. And let's see, this could be good. And let's, maybe this could be, that's a dead Zed. We'll be picking him up. And let's see, maybe will I live the heal coming out? This could be good. Nidalee coming in will pick me up. But let's see, Nex could try and get the Nidalee. He definitely will. That's game. That's game. That's game. That's... We just won. I'm actually 100% positive that we just won. Superman's crushing the... There's the surrender. We did it! Oh my god. That game was so stressful. Oh my goodness. Coming out on top with the victory there. God damn. 12, 11, and 20. Zed could have carried that game so much harder if he just didn't go for that absolutely stupid triple Infinity Edge build. Like, that was really... That was dumb on his part, honestly. Straight up, there's nothing else to say. That was not smart. But, goddamn. That game in general... Holy guacamole. Nexivus making so many plays. Everybody played phenomenally as that game went on. I can't even praise my team enough right there. But, anyways, you guys already saw the damage charts. If you want to see them again, here you go. We'll take a peek. We'll also look at the damage takings. I'm pretty curious. Nexivus right up there with me behind him in tail. Not surprised there. But here is the end of the scores. My rank A, not surprising. Here's the ending scores, ending builds, ending everything you would ever want to see in a game of League of Legends. If you guys did enjoy this video, though, make sure you do leave a like and a favorite. It does help me out. If you want to, you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, or Twitch. All three links will be in the description below this video. And as always, I love you guys. Have a wonderful day. Peace!